Welcome back. We have a few more things to cover. Let's start with tuples. Tuples are a bit like read-only lists. You initialize them just like a list, but with round brackets. And it's also a container. And these are, you can put any type of object inside, any type of variable. And since it's a container, you can also index. So here I'm printing the contents of my tuple starting from index 1. Now, tuples are very interesting in scientific computation to use them as indexes to dictionaries. So in this example, I create my dictionary, curly braces, and tuples can be keys of dictionaries. Lists cannot be keys of dictionaries because lists change, but tuples, because they cannot change, they can be keys, they can index the dictionary. And typically in scientific Python, you would use this if you run a simulation with several parameters. So you could use a dictionary to store the values. Here would be the parameters you use to run the simulation, and here would be the outcome, or say a NumPy array with the outcome. So you can iterate them exactly the same way as any other type of key from dictionaries. Sets. Sets are the unique elements of, say here we take a list and which has one repeated element, one. When you make this list into a set, then when you print, it will only have the unique elements of the list. And if you want to use then the unique elements as a list, then again you use list to recover just a list. And we treat it as you would use a list. Okay, we're almost at the end of our lecture. Let's talk about code inspection. Now borrow from this module called this. So try it out. You import this, and then you have the Zen of Python by Tim Peters. And I picked up a few of them that I think are very important or very relevant and for someone that is starting in Python and in coding in general. So whenever given a choice, it's better to be explicit than to be implicit. So don't assume that something happens, explicitly show that it happens. Or write that it happens. Given the choice, it's better to write something that is simple than something that is complex. And when you write your code, think about the readability. I mean, you can write shorter code, smarter code, but if somebody else is looking at your code and needs to think too much to understand, it's never a good, very good sign. So readability is very important. Okay, let's recap today's lecture. So we continued working on the LIF neuron and we learned how to structure code. So we saw dictionaries, Boolean indexes, broadcasting of NumPy arrays, functions. Then we saw classes and objects, modules, tuples, and sets. On the neuro side, we saw a histogram. Our LIF neuron started spiking and had a refractory period follow the spikes. And that's the end of part 2 and the end of our workshop. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've learned a few things and I hope they can be very useful for the NMA Academy and for your career. Thank you so much.